Welcome back to the channel. So this weekend we're off to the big truck and bus show with the White Rose Bus Group up in Whitley near Selby. So it's where the bus got converted. It's where we stored the bus for a year and a half to convert it. So we're up there to go and give a hand running the event, doing whatever they need us to do to make sure it's a nice smooth event. So we're just parked up in Rotherham at the minute. The bus is just there. So you're going to take us with you. We're going to take you with us today, should I say, while we get the bus ready for moving and sort of show you the process of what we have to do to move the bus, obviously to our next park, but obviously today up to the White Rose Bus Group HQ. So come with us today as we get ready to move. So the first thing we need to do is get power to the bus, which we've already done. We turn the isolator on because the destination board is now on, and that's hidden somewhere in the bus, not in its normal place. We've moved that. So that gives power to the bus for it to work. So the first thing we need to do is check the oil and the water, which is to the rear. Now obviously normally I'll show you that on here, but I've already done the oil and water yesterday, which is all good to go, so that's all done. So normally when you check the oil and the water, you check it around the back here. Obviously the dipstick is in the engine and the water's at the top there, but that's already done, did that last night before we left. So next off will be to start the bus up and get it running and let it warm up, and then we can do our checks that we do before we set off. So obviously we've got the screen on here that protects us, stops the drafts and also blocks the cab off when we're not using it. It has got a lock which I've undone just for reason, this can't do it one-handed, but this folds into the back and then this locks up here and then this swings around to block the stairs off. Morning girls, you're saying hello to everyone. Girls just came ready to move, and we just literally put a little elastic band around it here. Needs a good bit of a repaint that, and then it switch up. Oops, sorry. Yeah, and that just locks into there to hold that in place while we're traveling. So then that refills the cab. So now what we're going to do is get the bus started. So we need to make sure it's in neutral. This is a pre-select bus. So we're sending it across. Is that okay? Yep. So we're in neutral. Turn everything on and start her up. Just let her idle. So that's our buzzer to say that we've got low air, and that will go off when obviously the air tanks here fill up to where they need to be. So with that now, I'm going to put on our hazard lights. We're going to put on our lights are already on. So while we're in the cab, we can't check the window wipers yet because there's no air built up, but because they're air powered, so they won't work just yet. But we can check the horn. The horn is working. Then we'll go and do an exterior check of the bus. So it's very similar to sort of a walk around check that you do if you were a bus driver or a lorry driver, but I just do the normal little checks just to make sure we're right for when we're moving. So nothing's loose on the side, all the windows closed, our skylights are closed on the roof. Now I'm just checking the lights here. You might have seen them in the day on the camera, but they're all on, indicators on the side lights are on, which is fine. Check the wind mirror, make sure it's not loose, I'm gonna fall off. It's not, windows are all good, indicators working on the side. Check the tyres, all the nuts are good. I will look inside and just make sure all the tread's good on the tyre, which they are. Walk up the top here, windows, just checking as you go along. Then again, tyres, make sure they're inflated. Tread's alright, the nuts are all there, which they are. Going around the back, make sure the emergency door's closed. It is. Then at the back here, we're checking here. So we've got two indicators, tail lights are on. If you watch our YouTube video, or TikTok from yesterday, you can see me fixing the tail lights for the final time. Nothing there, skylights, windows are closed. And we should do the same this side again, so just checking up and down the body of the bus.
Make sure it's locked, like this trap door here is locked.
Tyres are good, good tread, all the nuts are there and they're inflated. And that brings you around again to the front of the bus, and the indicator's working this side. The only thing I need to check is full beam. Phoebe,
yeah?
You just jump in the cab and do the full beam for me, please. Is that red switch on the side, on top of that side one there? Can you see?
Yeah.
Right, Phoebe's going to check our full beam for me. Ooh. So, full beam, off, great, off. That's on, off again, that's it. Now hit the brake pedal for me. Can you just do the brake pedal for me? Brake pedal. Thank you. So just going to check the brake lights. Because there's nothing behind me, so I can't see the reflections. Let's have a look. Again. Yeah, they're working perfectly. So we're all good with that. So we are good to move. Let's give it 5 more minutes to warm up and then we'll make a move. So we've let the engine run for approximately about 10-15 minutes now, just to let it warm up, get the oil circulating in the engine, and then we're going to have a quite steady drive to start with. Where we parked up is very flat, so it's not going to be pushed or anything, just to get it warmed up before we hit on the dual carriageway, and obviously where we go a bit faster. Just protects the engine, keeps the bus happy, but all our air's up to standard now, and then we're just going to crack on now. Everything's all good, so let's see how we get on. There, down to the end, off road and down. To the bus shed, we've done some cleaning of some buses, there's some more to do still, which we'll do tomorrow. We're just going to start to do the repair to our roof. So we've had a leak in the main bedroom for the last couple of weeks when it's really heavy, get a couple of drips of water coming through. So we're going to basically, while we've got the ladders here, get up onto the roof, we're going to seal it or plate it. I've got a bit of plate here from the other side that we've already done, so we just need to have a look at that. But it's now chucking it down, I mean thunder and lightning, hailstoning it down. So we're just waiting for it to pass. It has just calmed down now, so we'll give it a couple of minutes. We'll get back outside on the ladders, get up on the roof and have a look and see where we're going, and hopefully I'm going to take you with you because I'm going to remember to record. It makes a change. So the rain stopped now, so we're going to get the ladders, which are there, tipped up the right way, and I can go to the bus roof then, which is above the main bedroom, to see what the damage is. So let's have a look what we got. Hello Nicole.
Hello.
So it's been only about 6 months since I've been on the roof, and that is what's causing us the trouble. Let's have a quick look at it. So yeah, I've already done a bit of sealing on it. I bet you there's not much holding that in though. Let's have a look, I'll get some tools and have a look. So a view that we don't get particularly much is the roof. So we have got four full size panels on here. So yeah, what we've got here then, so what have we got? So we've got a metal plate, this is what's leaking, metal plate to go over the top, our best friend, which is there, CT1, and a cloth. So I'm just going to get a couple of screws out of this down here and see how we get on, see if we can get that ripped out today while it is shining. And just as before, it is rotten, so let's put the screwdriver in and look, it's all just coming up. Yeah, see, it's all broken. So I think we're just gonna whip that off, get it cleaned up, and put the bracket on top, make it look right again. Not a bad view from up here though, but I don't like working that ladders. I have cut my hand open, which is very typical of me.
Somewhere, hold up microphone.
So the roof's done, it is trying to rain again. Here's my glamorous assistant Nicole. It was a bit rotten to say the least. I knew it was bad, but I didn't quite realise how bad it was. It's when I'm through, I can see why it was leaking with the ceiling that I put on. Obviously the gasket's done its job for the last, what, 40 odd years, it is original. So we've cleared that up. It's not the best of jobs, it's not pretty, but you're not going to see it, and it's now going to be watertight. We've used CT1 as well, which we can use if it rains, it's still going to seal. So yeah, all fun and games. Next job, let's wash it while we've got a jet wash. So we're going to move the bus around the corner and give it a good
and
wash.
Let's hope the rain holds off until we've washed it.
I'll be So that's it, that's the bus fully washed. It looks a bit cleaner. There's some proper dirt come off everything where we were using the jet wash. Just done the trick. So I'm now just gonna lock all the sheds up because we're the last ones here, and we're going to the pub for something to eat. I am starving. So yeah, let's get back on the road and go to the pub. Then we'll go find a park up for tonight and see where we're gonna stay. So we're about a 15 minute drive away in the bus, probably about 20 minutes in the bus, from Xscape in Castleford. There's a Wetherspoons there, so we're going to take a drive down to the Wetherspoons and get some grub for tea. I forgot how hard child work is cleaning buses, especially when you've done a couple. Even with like a few of you doing it, it's still a big job. Now, again, I've never taken the bus to Xscape before. I've been there in the car plenty of times. So we've had a quick look online to see if there's a coach park, and it's not very clear if there is a coach park. It just says to follow the signpost. So this is a new one for us, so we're gonna have a drive down and see what's what. We're on the M62 going west. We now have to do two junctions, so we're having a quick plod down there and see how we get on. Xscape, right, let's get across. So we're just pulling in now to the Xscape sort of like area, and there's no coach park. What's this parking sign here? It says overflow car park, main car park. Well, we'll go into Xscape. It's always busy here though, isn't it?
Yeah.
We'll go and have a butcher's, what we can find. I'm not going to get in the main car park, Nicole, that's for sure.
Yeah, it's
mad,
isn't it?
It's busy.
What about in Junction 32?
No, they've got high barriers in Junction 32. I can get here, like, but it's if I can get into the car park to get to there.
Yeah. It's not.
Where's the coach park? Coaches come here all the time.
Yeah, there's probably a coach park somewhere.
I'll go straight over because that's a bus route. So, oh, hold on, there's. No, that's, no, I don't know. Let's have a butcher's. Welcome to bus life in the UK. Not necessarily the easiest thing to park. I can definitely get in the car park. I've got the confidence to drive it round. And I know this is a bus route from being here before. Oh, speed bump, hold on. Oh, there's no height restriction in there, Nicole.
No, I was just looking at that. There's like quite a lot of double sparks.
And yeah, it's only going to get quieter, isn't it?
Yeah. I know, we're one of them frustrating people.
I know, sorry, I'm taking. Let's have a look.
We do try to go for coach parks, but when there's not a coach park.
Service vehicles.
We don't really have much choice.
Oh, I know, I think. Let's have a look down here. I found somewhere. So we've found a space and Xscape. It's just like a normal car park, but it's empty, so we'll go with that. A couple of spaces in there, and then I'll make sure I park in a space where I can easily get out. So we'll do a bit of maneuvering, but we will get that sorted then. That looks like a good one there. I've got a nice swing on it out of that one there. Right, you ready? It says you must be parked in bays only, so as long as I'm in a bay, we'll be fine. Right, take a tight turn here. And then I am parking it here, quite literally. And then from there, I can take a sharp right out and get out. Even if I have to go back a bit, I can still make the angle, Nicole.
Yeah.
Sorry, I'm just talking to myself, just to get used to it. So we'll go with it there. Now let's go and check to make sure, turn the indicators off. I'll take you with me. We'll go and see how we're looking at the back. Ooh, let's have a look. Let's do the thing. Let's have a butcher's. So we're sort of in. Let me spin you around. I'll show you. Do 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 do. Here we go. So we've got a bit of room at the front. Actually, we can come forward a bit more if we need to. Let's have a look at the back. It's looking nice and clean now. We had a wash there. I was worried going down the road it might have made it mucky again, which is not too bad. Oh look, we're in there, look. We're just in, look. Can live with that. Brilliant. I've left this space here, so we should be able to turn right to get out, but I don't think it's going to get very busy. So, that's a good one. And then we'll go get something to eat, because I am starving. I need something in my belly now. So yeah, I'll go to the Wetherspoons.
Hi guys, and now we are just going to go on the sky coaster at Xscape, and we're all going on it, so yeah.
So we're just coming to Xscape thinking it'll all be closed. It's all open, so the girls are going to go on something called the sky coaster, which basically starts there and goes all the way around the building on this red track around to the other side. Now Phoebe's done it before and so has Poppy, but Luna and Summer are now tall enough to go on, so we're going to give it a go and see how we get on. I guess it's all in the fun of bus life and having the freedom to be able to afford extra things like this, which is great. Very colourful. There goes Luna. They call Luna Daredevil. They're screaming. So that's been the sky coaster here at Xscape by the Gravity Group. $5.95, which is not bad because they got all the harness in. Obviously, someone pushing over the hill and going round. They've had a great time, so let's go and see what the kids thought about their ride on the sky coaster. How was it, girls?
Good.
What was the best bit?
Going round the corner.
Dropping down.
You're dropping down?
Going down the hill.
Going down the hill. Should we do it again?
Yeah.
That's
yeah.
Good then. So we've just done an Xscape. Everyone's just walking back here. And it's dark, I've got to get used to this getting late malarkey earlier. We're just walking back up to the bus and there's now no one in the car park at all, so I can spin straight out. So it's been a good little park up that for coming here. So we'll put that in as book as we can park here later on. Like I say, that sky coaster was fantastic. You've really enjoyed it, haven't you, Phoebe?
Yeah.
It's been really good and it's been a nice just chill out evening. So we're now going to take a drive back up to Whitley. We found this park up for tonight, which is a layby on a very quiet road. We stopped there once before, when we first moved onto the bus, it's where we spent our first night. It's not far from the shed, which is great. There's a car boot in the morning we're going to go to.
Yay!
It's actually the site where we're having the event on Monday. It's a car boot every Sunday, so we're going to get there in the morning and go from there. So yeah, see you tomorrow. It's 5:30 on Monday morning, it's a bit early, but we're here, the shed's open, there's a few buses here already, there's a Sprinter, there's our bus and a bus from Arriva as well, just been repainted, looks pretty nice. So just waiting for everyone to turn up and then we've got access from the site from 6 in the morning to start taking buses around and getting stuff ready. It's going to be a long hog this one to get stuff done, but we'll crack on and get it on. So let's see how it goes. It's a bit cold, I know, I've got my jumper on for the first time in forever. But hey ho, let's go. Functioning road legal above the board. There was obviously a
to the restoration and not worry of coming out. I only need bits and bobs. So the burger van's turned up, the front fair's turned up. There's no rain, so we're winning at the minute. So we're just going to drop now at the bus stops round for the free bus services through the bus stop. We're going to take a bus in fashion to get it done. It's easy in carrying them. Oh, the door's open. Straight down to the bottom then. Holy dog.
So now we're there, we're just looking at stores they've got. So we've got a lot of stalls. Got some more stalls here. Let's zoom in. And we've got some here. A lot more stalls as well. Stalls. So here we've got lots of books about buses. We've got lots of buses, but when you've got some more pizza, got food place, got some food stalls here. There's a big queue for that one. We've got swinging chairs. Got this coach which I love. Then we've got another one here. Got another book. And another one here. Got another coach. So yeah, we've got this one. We've got Mackenzie coaches. We've got this one. And here we've got this one. And this one. I really like this one. And we've got this one. And there's lots of buses. So yeah. So here we've got another one. A lot more still. Here we've got a truck, a lorry. We've got another bus. And we've got some old trucks which I really like. Then we've got Yorkshire Rescue trucks. Got another one here, and we've got this one which I really like, and we've got another one, and we've got Yorkshire Rider again, recovery trucks, and we've got some, and we've got a tractor here, so when we've got more Yorkshire Rescue, when here we've got, well here we have got lots more trucks. So we've got trucks. Another one. We've got lots. Rainbow stagecoach. Got a lorry. Got a bus. Got another one. Got another one. And a lot. That's a lot of buses. We've got these two buses. So yeah.